This style of harp guitar became more of the rage in the early 20th century. There were these two Swedish guys, the Larsson brothers, who ended up emigrating to the United States, and they became full-time luthiers in the States. And they made guitars for a variety of different brand names. So you might find guitars with brand names from back then, brand names Prairie State, or Maurer, or Dyer, a bunch of different brand names. Those are all Larsson Brother guitars. And the Dyer harp guitar was made by those guys. And they were all the rage, beginning of the 20th century, in guitar orchestras. They would pull down the bottom end. And then Michael Hedges sort of caused a resurgence in interest in the instrument in the 80s, because he started touring with one, playing Israel Space Age music on it. And that's where I first actually heard anybody play one. So I learned to play one all those years ago by borrowing one for a long time. And then I didn't have one in my hands for a better part of 30 years. And then I was touring in Italy, India. India, just like Italy. And I met a harp guitar builder who made clones of the Dyer harp guitar. So I picked it up and I could actually still play it. My chops were still kind of there. So I called up Mark and I said, would you make me one play? So, you know, another thing that he never had to do for any other, because he never had anybody, you know, foolish enough to ask for one before. But we did the R&D. As you may have heard me say last night, I'll tell you the slightly longer version of the story. I went to this thing called the Harp Guitar Gathering. There is such a thing. It's like a comic-con for harp guitarists. And I got invited because I put a cover of a Michael Hedges tune to play them a harp guitar when I first got it up on YouTube. And everybody went, oh, hey, Don's playing harp guitar. I was going to come play our thing. So I performed for this gathering of geeks. And then the guy who's the world headquarters of harp guitar, his name is Glenn Miner, who's in Southern California. He kept yelling during my set, that sounds so beautiful! Great, nice to meet you too. And then afterwards he came up to me and said, Don, it's just good. I normally don't like the sound of plugged in harp guitars, but that one sounded amazing. Can I just try it acoustically? So I was just sitting on a table like this, and so he just came up to it and said, says, oh my God, he says, you tell Mark Beneteau, I've seen them all, I've heard them all, I've played them all, and he hit a home run on his very first one. So that's like 30 grand worth of tone in that instrument. So I called Mark and went, so, anyway, he just made a Mark Beneteau guitar the way he normally would as a harp guitar, and it turned out great. They normally sound really boxy, you know, because they're overbuilt for the most part, but he managed not to overbuild this one. Which is why I'm always looking at it to make sure the glue is still holding. It's a lot of string pressure. I'm going to have to retune. I'm going to play something different than I played last night. Get it back in the standard tuning. So you can tune, again, the harp guitar in any old way you want.
Isn't that a fabulous camera?
Yeah, I've been enjoying it. Make a zoom.
I went to buy a big lens. You won't need one with your new camera. And I said, what new camera? He said, this one I'm going to sell you. And I was like, oh.
Did you? You got the same one? Interesting.
We wrote a lot of songs back then together. The man is Tom. He'll come to me eventually. And Linda Creed is her name. She was the lyricist. Tons of tunes that got covered by a whole lot of different soul groups back then. And also this song, eventually Prince did a version of it. But it was a huge hit for a band called Stylistics. About 1971. And it's got a silly name called Bet You Bite Lolly Well. And I already had a version of this arranged for standard guitar. And it suddenly occurred to me when I got the harp guitar that it would be awesome to figure it out on this instrument. Because it's a piece in two keys. It again appealed to my music theory nature. Because the two keys are minor third apart, it's my favorite thing ever.
this is the kind of thing, you know, if you want to, you know, first met a girl when I'm dating, you know, I always have to ask her how she felt about Timmy. And it's a correct answer, so that was always nice to know there. And so this tune, it starts in the key of E major, and if you're watching carefully, you'll see it goes to the key of G major, and the transition between the two keys is really beautiful. And so I figured out that if I can tune the bottom four strings in the key of E to a little scale pattern, G sharp, A, D, C sharp. So in the key of E, that's notes 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then the top two strings, D and G, are 5 and 1 in the key of G. So it worked out really well for this piece. So, got myself a 6-day and 2 by the world. This is called Betcha by Golly Wow. It's on my ear.
Big enough to be a guitar, which is getting increasingly difficult to do, of course. But crazy. Other questions about the Harp guitar?
Yes. Or just in general?
In general.